don't even know what to say right now. I'm just really, really thankful, really ecstatic that I even have this opportunity to be here.
Neither profit nor politics entered in these graduate students' minds when they thought up the winning entry at the 2017 Hollomon Health Innovation Challenge. Their entry, EpiForAll, is a self-administered, reusable allergy injector.
So when this is pressed against the thigh, these prongs right here will push on the spring.
The idea began as a class assignment.
So it didn't actually start as a business idea. It started as an idea to save preventable deaths. Initially, we were just looking to target these low-resource countries internationally, but then we started to see the need arise more in America.
So the engineering students kept working.
We're the first ampule-based auto-injector. So that means when our drug expires every 18 months, instead of throwing out the entire device for $650, we can just replace this ampule of epinephrine, and this only costs 50 cents.
That would be a huge cost breakthrough. EpiForAll, made largely of plastic and springs, is expected to be made available for just a few dollars in developing countries by 2018.
And I'm just really excited to see where this goes.
So we can adjust the cap segment to a fuller length. Playgate is a non-electronic exoskeleton. It's affordable for families, and it's meant to help kids with cerebral palsy and other kind of neurological walking disorders learn to walk and get practice outside of therapy.
Months after Playgate's second place finish in the Hollomon Health Challenge, this student design is ready to begin tests at local hospitals and clinics.
So this, with the natural action of our tendon that comes from the hip to the knee to the ankle, it stores and returns energy during walking, so the kids are upright, and then they shift weight off their hip, and this guides their leg forward with the right range of motion.
1 year after winning the 2016 challenge, Xylene Biotech is a new business in the tiny field of personal cell preservation.
We specifically work with induced pluripotent stem cells. We can process them and isolate the necessary cells, and then we can store them long-term for future use with the thought that your younger cells are better for future use because they're less aged and mutated.
Working from two different buildings at the UW, Silene coordinates and processes the blood, saving stem cells before sending them for cold storage in the Midwest.
So currently people are using patients' own white blood cells to treat their cancer. This is called cell therapy. There are other clinical trials out there for diseases like heart disease, spinal cord injury, type 1 diabetes, and even Parkinson's. So there's a lot of therapies that are going to come online using regenerative medicine. So there's a lot of potential to regrow tissues and organs.
And again, we hear that the business would not have been possible without many mentors and benefactors, both on and off campus.
For students out there who think that, you know, maybe these competitions are just something to do, you can learn a lot, you can gain a lot of experience, but you can also start companies out of these competitions.